Hi guys, welcome to Ek Guru channel. So in this channel, so I am going to upload the videos which are related to electrical stream. So that consists of theory, concepts and problems. And also I will upload the practical videos which are very interesting and helpful. So before going to the video, please don't forget to subscribe the channel. In this video, so we are going to discuss about how to identify shorted turns in the field winding in a synchronous generator or synchronous motor. So for a synchronous generator or synchronous motor, so one of the major problem with the rotor winding is shorted turns in the field winding. So these shorted turns will exist in the rotor winding. So because of the aging of the machine, or because of the thermal stresses of the machine, or on-off cycles, nothing but we will give the supply to the rotor winding whenever we need the generator voltage, and we will turn off the DC supply whenever we don't need the generated voltage. So because of these on-off cycles also, shorter turns will exist in the field poles. And another reason for the shorter turns is contamination, nothing but so if you are talking about the large generators and large synchronous motors, bearing needs cooling. So that cooling can be arranged by using the lubricating oil or water. So these water or oil particles will contaminate the rotor field poles, so that will cause the shorter turns in the poles. So what these shorter turns in the field winding will do? So these shorter turns in the field winding may reduce the machine's capability to deliver the VAR, nothing but. So if the field pole is having the shorter turns, so that will reduce the net flux generated by the field poles. Thereby, the machine will reduce the capacity to deliver the rated reactive power. And these shorter turns will cause the rotor vibrations. So whenever there are shorter turns are present, there is an unbalance in the air gap flux density. So that unbalanced air gap flux will generate the rotor vibrations. And these shorter turns in the field winding can be developed into a ground fault. And then, so these shorter turns in the field winding may increase the rotor winding temperature. Nothing but if a field pole is having the shorter turns, so that will decrease the net reactance, and thereby that will increase the current drawn from the supply. So thereby the rotor winding temperature will increase. So it is very important to identify so which pole is having the shorter turns. So that can be identified effectively by using so two methods broadly. So one is the online technique, another one is the offline technique. The online technique for finding the shorter turns, so by monitoring the rotor flux. So that we will call it as the RFM, rotor flux monitoring technique. So the another offline techniques, so nothing but offline technique means we are not synchronizing the unit to the grid, nothing but we are not generating any active power or reactive power. So these offline techniques for testing the existence of shorter turns, or so with the rotor at a speed, at a rated speed, the methods are, so we are plotting the graph of impedance versus speed, or RSO versus speed. So by using this, we can identify which pole is having the shorter turns. Or another offline method is when the rotor is at a standstill, so we can identify the rotor shorted turns by using the pole drop method, pole drop test, or by using the RSO or C code test. So here, so we are concentrating on the simple test, that is nothing but pole drop test in a offline technique. So but we will see the online technique in a brief manner. So in a online detection method, the rotor flux monitoring technique is used. So this rotor flux monitor technique means, as name indicates, so we are monitoring the air gap flux or rotor flux by placing a sensor at the tooth of stator winding. So here we can see, so this is a sensor, so which is placed on the face of a stator tooth. So it will monitor the rotor flux, so thereby so we can have the rotor flux plot. From that rotor flux plot we can identify so which pole is having the shorted turns. So and in offline detection method, the pole top test is very simple and easy, so that we will discuss now. The common way to detect the shorted turns is to perform pole drop test. The pole drop test is very easy. So in pole drop test, we are applying an AC voltage to the rotor winding at the slip rings, and so we will measure the voltage across each pole. So if any of the pole is having the voltage drop which is less than the average voltage, so that pole is having the shorted turns. Okay, so that we will see in detail. So here I am assuming an alternator or a synchronous motor is having the 6 poles, and so I'm applying the voltage using a dimmer stat or a variac. So variac is nothing but it is a variable transformer. The input voltage is 230 volts. The output voltage we can vary from 0 to 270 volts. By using variac, so I am applying the voltage to the slip rings. The positive is connected to phase, negative is connected to neutral, or we can interchange the terminals because it's a AC supply. And then, so here, so from the slip rings, the rotor winding is like this. So this is the pole number 1, and then the pole number 2, pole number 3, 4, 5, 6. All 6 poles are connected in series. So whatever voltage we are applying here, so that will distributed across the 6 poles depending upon the impedance of the poles. If the impedance is high, then more voltage will drop across the pole. Generally, so these 6 poles are identical, so then the voltage should be equal if there are no shorted turns. So here, for convenience, I am applying the voltage of 120 volts across the slip rings. If the poles is not having any shorted turns, then each pole should have a voltage drop of 20 volts. Okay, so here I am applying the voltage with the variac, and then I am measuring the voltage across pole 1. So that is the, by using a multimeter, we can measure the voltage across pole 1. Then that I am calling it as a VP1. Similarly, I will measure the voltage across pole 2, VP2, and the voltage across pole 3, VP3. So like that, so you have to measure the voltage across the 6 poles. So here, so these are the voltages I got. Pole number 1 is having the voltage of 20.98, pole number 2 21.22, pole number 3 14.62, 21.35, 20.86, 21.33. So here, by calculating the average of 6 voltages, the average voltage is 20 volts. So from these readings, so what we can see here, the pole number 3 as having the voltage which is less than the average voltage, that pole number 3 is having the shorted turns. So from these readings we can say, so this pole number 3 is having the shorted turns. So here the process is simple. We are applying the voltage by using variac, and we are measuring the voltage across all poles. If any of the pole is having the voltage which is less than the average voltage, so that will have the shorted turns. So here, for accuracy, we can calculate the deviations from the average value. If the deviation is greater than the 5%, that pole is having the shorted turns. So deviations is nothing but the actual value minus the average value. So this pole drop test is very easy. So if the number of poles are less, if the number of poles in a rotor winding is 20 or greater than 30, 40, so then it is very difficult to conduct the pole drop test. So like this, this poll of test is having significant disadvantages. So one is, it can be performed with the motor or generator is in idle condition, nothing but whenever it is in rest position. And it is a time consuming to perform, especially on large rotor with many poles. The third one is, since the rotor is not rotating, so here we are not counting the centrifugal forces. So because some of the shorter turns in the field poles will exist whenever there are centrifugal forces, nothing but whenever there is a rotation, so then only the shorter turns will exist. So that cannot be identified by using the pole drop test. So but now this pole drop test is very simple and easy to perform. We don't need any hi-fi equipment, we just need a variac and a multimeter. So but as far as the identification of shorter turns is concerned, the RFM method, nothing but rotor flux monitoring method, the online technique, that is very useful and reliable. So that we will see in the next video. Thank you so much.